My name is Marc Weinstein. I founded Amoeba Music with my partner Dave back in 1990. Worked in record stores since 1975. This is my 40th year working in retail records, and it's basically the only job I've ever had. Well, I was technically born in Parkersburg, West Virginia. A few years later, my dad got a job in Buffalo, and I stayed there from about 3 years old on. And did all my schooling there. You know, started playing the drums when I was 9 years old and played in a bunch of bands. Went to hundreds of concerts in those days. Consider it to a great extent to have been kind of my own personal church or spiritual journey was all through music. I know I share a lot of memories and quote nostalgia for that era with everyone in my generation and especially my friends. Sometime starting in the mid-80s, I think I was getting a little antsy. For 7 years, I was a manager at Streetlight Records in San Francisco, and it was a really fun job, a really great kind of community record store, although it lacked, the space and kind of the size and kind of resources to do it to the extent that I wished it could be done. I really believe that inspired me more than anything. I remember a visit with the owner of that small chain of record stores. After visiting him and seeing his whole setup with his art studio and his view of the ocean, and I was driving home, I was like, I just can't do this anymore for like 10 bucks an hour. I gotta start a store. And that was somewhere in the later 80s. I met my partner Dave in 89, so at that point I was kind of raring to go, and he was busy looking for another business to do, so we kind of figured it all out during 89, 90. Yeah. Being someone who works at the buy counter in my store quite often, that's a place where you really learn a lot about people. Maybe the most of the customers are people you don't necessarily know, but when someone lays out their 50 records they're getting rid of, or 100 records, and you go through those records, you have learned actually so much about where they came from. I can almost tell you what high school year they graduated and what kind of drugs they were doing and whatever. I mean, there's really so much in that, so much revealing stuff in that little pile of records that people don't even realize. But if you're a record buyer, you kind of know a lot about them if just from looking at their records, you know.